The outside temperature over a day can be modeled as a sinusoidal function. Suppose you know the high temperature for the day is 96 degrees and the low temperature of 64 degrees occurs at 4 a.m. Assuming T is the number of hours since midnight, find an equation for the temperature D in terms of T. So because we can model the temperature using a sinusoidal function, we'll use either the sine function graphed here in blue or the cosine function graphed here in red. So we want to gather enough information from this problem to determine the equation of a possible sinusoidal function. Well, first, because the high temperature is 96 degrees and the low temperature is 64 degrees, if we find the average of these two, we should be able to find the midline of our sinusoidal function. So 96 plus 64 divided by 2, which is equal to 160 divided by 2, which is equal to 80, which means a horizontal line, y equals 80, is the midline of our sinusoidal function. Next, since a low temperature of 64 degrees occurs at 4 a.m., and t is the number of hours after midnight, we know that d of 4 must equal 64, which means our function would contain the point 464. But also, since a day is 24 hours, we know the period of our function would be 24. So if we add 24 to 4, d of 28 would also equal 64. So our function would also contain the point 2864. And then finally, since the period is 24 hours, the max and mins must occur 12 hours apart. And since 4 plus 12 is equal to 16, this means d of 16 must equal the high temperature of 96 degrees. So our function must contain the point 1696. And we also said the period of our function must equal 24 hours. So let's go ahead and plot this information on the coordinate plane and then determine a possible sinusoidal function. Let's first plot the three points. The first point plotted here was the point 464. And then we said it also contains the point 2864, which should be here. Then the high point is the point 1696. Our midline is y equals 80. Now to graph this, we'll divide it into four equal parts. So we're going to start here, stop here, cut it in half, and then cut it in half again. Now we'll sketch a sinusoidal graph through these points, which would look something like this. So while we do have the option of using either the sine function or cosine function, we should recognize this graph as a transformation of the basic cosine function sketched here in red. We should also recognize that our graph has been reflected across the x-axis. The amplitude has changed, the period has changed, the graph has been shifted right, and the graph has also been shifted up. Which means to find the equation of our function in terms of cosine, we'll have to determine the values of a, b, d, and c in this form here. So for a quick review, for both the sine and cosine functions, the absolute value of a is equal to the amplitude. But remember, if a is negative, the graph is reflected across the x-axis. B affects the period, where 2 pi divided by b is equal to the period. The value of d affects the phase shift. If we have x minus d, the graph is shifted right d units. If we have x plus d, the graph is shifted left d units. Then the value of c affects the shift up or down. If we have plus c, the graph is shifted up c units. If we have minus c, the graph is shifted down c units. So going back to our function, we're going to focus on this piece of the graph. So let's start by determining the value of a. Remember, the absolute value of a is equal to the amplitude, which is the distance from the midline to the maximum, or from the midline to a minimum. Well, 96 minus 80 is 16, so the amplitude is 16. But because this graph has been reflected across the x-axis, a is actually negative 16. We know our graph has been reflected because, looking at our graph, the pattern is a minimum, midline, maximum, midline minimum, and for the basic cosine function, it starts with a maximum, then midline minimum, midline maximum. Next, the value of B affects the period, and because one day is 24 hours, our period is 24 hours, which means 2 pi divided by B must equal 24. So now we need to solve this for B, so we'll multiply both sides by B. That'll give us 2 pi equals 24B. Divide both sides by 24. And we have B equals, this would be 1 pi divided by 12, or pi over 12. So now we have the values of A and B. Now we need to find the values of D and C. Well, the value of D affects the shift left or right, or the horizontal shift. Notice how our graph has been shifted right 4 units, which means this must be in the form of x minus 4. And since the minus is already in our equation, D is equal to positive 4. And then finally, C affects the shift up or down, or the vertical shift. Because our midline is y equals 80, we know our graph has been shifted up 80 units, and therefore C is equal to positive 80. Now that we have the values of A, B, D, and C, we can write the equation of our cosine function. Remember, our function is D in terms of T, so we have D of T equals negative 16 times cosine of B, which is pi divided by 12, times the quantity x minus d, so it's x minus 4, and then plus 80. This would be a sinusoidal function that we can use to model the temperature over the 24-hour period. I hope you found this explanation helpful.